use these guide bars is because with different systems where you just run along the wood, the saw always has a tendency to pull to one side, constantly catching on things like this. So my idea was to run over these guide bars with guide shoes on the mill, so that I don't really have to steer the mill, and I can just remotely control the mill.
Thank you.
watching my video on chainsaw milling, I'll just give a quick explanation how I built this mill. I use two 120cc motors. This is a steel 084 and the other end has a steel MS-880. I have fitted these with remote throttles, just a very simple system, just using a brake line and just drill a hole through the throttle lever. This is the winch I use to pull the mill through the wood. This is connected to a 12 volt battery. This is a 12 volt winch, and this gives me a maximum feed rate of 16 millimeters per second. I have replaced the metal wire with rope, so this does have a little slack in it, so if my mill would stall for some reason, it wouldn't destroy the whole bar. And I can control the speed of the winch with this control box. With this button I can very fluidly control the speed, and I can also go forward and reverse. And these are the remote throttles for the 084 and for the MS-880, so I can just give full throttle on these and just control the speed. So I've been milling two slabs of the beech log with the new dual and the chainsaw mill I made. I just want to show you the actual reason why I started building the dual and the chainsaw mill. This because of this log that I bought. This is also a beech log, and this one the biggest diameter is 1 meter and 85 centimeters, and then it is 5 meters long, and the other end is smaller diameter, but it weighs at 9.5 tons, so this really is a really big log. I actually know where the tree has stood. It is in a city not too far from here, so I'll just give you guys a quick walk around of the log so you can see what it looks like. It is very gnarly. It has a lot of branches coming out and stuff, but I think this will give a lot of nice slabs. But with my chainsaw mill, even with the long bar I bought, which is a 78-inch bar. No, 87-inch bar from Alaska Mill, UK. And I can just barely cut this log. So I'll keep you guys up to date when I start milling this log. I'll try to make another video. And thank you for watching, and if you have any questions about the mill, please drop them in the comments below.